This 2D game is to put the helicopter at the right altitude where the long horizontal green line is. The challenge is, the input button or the up arrow if you are using a desktop, it only applies the up force at the very moment when the button is clicked. Otherwise, the gravitational force will pull down the helicopter. To emphasize, all you deal with here is the acceleration, not velocity. On the other hand, what you're looking at is the position of the helicopter. The relationship between the position and acceleration is second-order polynomial function, whose change is small at the beginning. However, the amount of change gets larger as you go. Therefore, once you start the game, you will soon realize pushing the button preemptively is challenging. This makes the game very difficult for humans to play it for a long time. Indeed, this needs to be done in real life when making an autonomous drone. Maintaining a precise altitude of the drone with the manual stick is also a challenge. Understanding and solving the problem using this game is better than taking a typical control engineering course from a college, most of which talks about these kinds. However, you do not need to understand the Laplace transformation to make an autopilot maintain its altitude. Let me show you how to do this in Python in 5 minutes. Now, to begin with, if you click this link, then it'll direct you to a GitHub repo and then just clone this. And I have this in my desktop. And then, like the instruction says, I have installed this Ubicoders vRobots. Next step I'm going to do is to run the bridge. As soon as you run this, you'll have this window pop up. And then go back to the simulation and then just click connect button. Now, as you can see, the helicopter is active, you're ready to go. And then from the script, I'm going to open up new command and I'll just run this sample demo file. Python myheli.py. And I run this, then the helicopter will go up, but it just goes up forever, right? And that's because I just set force as 16 Newton for whatever it is. It doesn't have any feedback loop. First things first, let's go over this demo script really quick. The first line is just importing the necessary packages from this Ubicoder PIP system, and then we are creating a helicopter instance like this, and then this heli is called in this loop, heli.states, and then print it. And then we are printing all these position and the velocity of the helicopter in real time from this simulation. And then we're going to use this states.pose or states.val.z. We're going to use these values to feedback and then change these values in this loop. And the main function is just boiler template to run this simulation. Like I said in the previous video, if you have ever done Arduino project before, this structure should look very familiar to you. So this setup function is called only once at the very beginning of this script, and then this loop is called forever while this script is connected to this simulation, and then this simulation will communicate with this for loop and then spits out all these necessary states. By the way, I realized I needed to add these two lines just to handle the known case. This known case happens when the script just started to connect with this simulation. The default is known, so that's why I just need to do this. Anyways, that's just a part of the boiler templates. Now, what I'm going to do to maintain this helicopter at 5 meters, which is green bar, to maintain this altitude, what I'm going to do is just define the concept of error instead of just constant value. Because when error is large, I'm going to increase this value largely, and then when the error is small, the input is going to be small, and that's my simple guess. And to do that, I'm just defining error like this. My target value is 5 meters, which is at the green bar, and then my current helicopter position is heli_states.pose.z, and that's my z value of the helicopter, which is the height of the helicopter. So as the error changes, this set force should be changed. So I'm going to put error here, simply. Then let me see what's going to happen. Python myheli.py. And then nothing actually happens. And that's because the maximum error in this case is only 5, because pools.z is 0, so this error is 5. But previously it was 16. That means it needs at least 16 newton to lift up this helicopter, and 5 newton, which is current error, is not really enough. So simply what I'm going to do is just scaling up this error, say by 5. Now let me see. Well, that's good. The helicopter is kind of oscillating, and that's because when this helicopter reaches to this green bar, it reduces the force, and then it's too low, and then the helicopter is coming back down and then going up again, and so on and so on. And this happens because the helicopter, when it reaches to a certain level, it doesn't really break. So if I may use metaphors like this, you are driving in a car, you see a red traffic light, and you reduce the amount of gas pedal that you are stepping on. But the thing is, you never stepped on the brake to stop at the right position. This is the limitation of just using the error. So I'm going to use a brake. How do I define that? Well, I do have the information about the velocity, and I'll make this velocity as a brake. So that the velocity is too high, then I will brake more amount, as much as the velocity. So simply I'm going to minus heli.states.vel.z. So it looks like not much of difference, but as you can see, this amount of oscillation is reduced, and then eventually the helicopter is kind of stopping. Although it didn't reach this bar anyway, but it stopped the oscillation, and that's the effect of this brake effect using the velocity information. Now, as you can see, this oscillation of the helicopter was stopped. The rate of stopping is too low, so what I'm going to do is just multiply this brake effect by 10, and let me see how it behaves. So it rises really slowly, and then it doesn't even oscillate. So that's the effect that I wanted to achieve. And then the last question would be, how can we make this helicopter stop at right here, instead of here or there and so on? Well, since we are using the concept of error, we can just integrate the error through time. I mean, just keep adding the error here somehow. And then if the error is integrated to a certain amount, then that must be the extra force that we can add here. I'm going to say self.error integration, or error sum. Say self error sum is 0 at the beginning. And then as the iteration goes on, I'm going to add self.error sum plus error like this. And then simply adding the error sum here. And let's see how it behaves. Okay, I think that's a lot of overshoot because of the error sum here, which is too large. And then simply like I did here, I'm going to reduce by a certain number, I don't know, say 0.1. And then I'm going to rerun this script. Now let me see how it goes. Okay, Rich is there, but it didn't stop well as before because this error sum is another kind of bumping up force against the brake. So what I'm going to do is increase the brake force to reduce the error sum. Oh, by the way, we have anyway ended up with this right position. And I just wanted to make it faster response. So I'll increase that by 15 and then just run this again. Let me see if I can just stop it right there. Didn't really. In this case, I'll just reduce this 0.1 further down to say 0.08 or something like that. But hey, anyway, we have achieved our goal to solve this game. Now, you can always implement a high control algorithm for autonomous drone in Python, and the exact idea will apply for embedded system. You don't really need to go through Laplace transformation, which is mostly covered by sophomore control engineering course, which is really not necessary to be able to implement one like this. So I think that's it for today's video. Thank you for watching.